Okay. So whatever that I'm doing on the presentation, it will also be available for all of you. So you can recap what all you have heard. Right? It's very, very important. Sometimes you hear the session, there is some distraction, you had to leave early, you skipped a session. There are a lot of them who have said, please record these. And I thought just audio recording is not good enough. So I'm recording even the slides. You don't need to see my face, but at least you can see the slides and you know the audio along with it, right? So the fundamental question that today is the second session. We'll try to go a little fast today because I thought actually I will finish the Maha Mantra in half an hour to 45 minutes, but it turned out to be more than an hour, right? More than 1.5 hours. What is the time now? 6:30. So please forgive me, sometimes these sessions go a little overboard because I'll tell you spiritual process the way it works, not that I'm a pure person, but when we start speaking about spiritual subjects, it all depends on the listener's inquisitiveness. And the Supreme Lord inspires me to give more examples and more explanations, right? It's not a mechanical subject that I will say A after B, B is for bat, C is for cat, right? You have to go sometimes to explain a little further. And I don't want these sessions to be one-sided. We have had enough one-sided sessions in life. I want all of you to ask, I think I'm getting very nice questions like Prabhuji asked, Mataji asked. This is very important that we should clarify everything as we go forward. The point is not to finish 12 sessions. After 12 sessions, if we'll remain what we are, what is the whole point? Right? So better clarify. There might be a 15 minutes to half an hour, sometimes up and down in our session time. I please humbly request you. There are some of you are coming from a far off distance, some of you are coming from a nearby distance. Yes, I want to be punctual. I'm a perfectionist myself. If you work under me, you leave me in 2 days. But when it comes to spiritual life, I become a little flexible. Right? Because it is for your interest and this is a voluntary service being done by some individuals here. If you can see that person in the green dress, you know, towards the, to near the door, he was a delivery head for 3,000 people. He's sitting here and doing this service because there is a good reason why, you know. So there are people who are doing a lot of sacrifice for these sessions to happen and for all of you to come here and benefit from these sessions. And prasadam is being arranged, books are being kept ready for you, chanting bags are brought. These bags were brought in Vrindavan Dham. They are coming from Rajbhumi, right? And they have been given to you. So you can take this back to your house. During Navaratri time, you can chant. If you want to donate a little amount for us bringing this back, whatever that you think is good, you can leave in the donation box. And those books, some of the books, you know, I've brought some of them directly from US. You know, when my friend was coming, he just got 2 bags because they were available in that hardbound way there. If you see the dollar price behind, it is what it is. You can even see in the Amazon. But we want you to read it. So some of us have sponsored it and brought it down like 700 for one book and 500 for one book, but you will not find it less than 1800. The point is what? What are we trying to do here? I'm not saying we are doing a favor on you. Actually, you are doing a favor on us by giving this service to us. But at the same time, I want you to reciprocate in the similar mood that, you know, sessions will be a little up and down. Sometimes there will be 15 minutes up and down, so half an hour up. But please bear with me because you are the one who is going to benefit out of it. Right, and we all seek forgiveness from every one of you that sometimes we are not able to match to your expectation. Please bear with us and someday we'll become perfect like you. Thank you. So does God exist? How many have this question? Does God exist? Let's be sincere. So it's an applicable session. If none of you would have lifted, then I would have thought, you know, then I need the session better more than you. Does God exist? And is God somebody made out of our imagination? So, where is the mic? Can you pass on? Any comments? Is God made by a human? Or is God actually existing? Anybody wants to say anything?
What do you mean by God? What is God?
What is God?
Yeah,
what do you mean by God?
Know whether he exists or he exists or not. What is God?
What is the definition of God? Is that right? Very. Your name, sir?
Praveen
Garu. Excellent question. And that I will cover as we go towards the end of presentation. Because there is no point in worshipping a God who doesn't have a definition.
So when
right?
We do not know the definition now, how can we say whether he exists or not?
Exactly. We'll get to that point. Definitely. It's a good question. And I'm sure it will be answered by the end of the session. Yeah.
Prabhuji,
yes.
Basic question is, where is God?
Where is God? Is he everywhere? Or is he only in the temple?
Minds or our whatever.
Exactly. Is he sitting in my heart? Or is he everywhere? Or is he sitting only inside the murti? Or, you know, is he not everywhere outside? Why I only have to go to a temple?
Yeah,
Yeah, go ahead.
I have been to some temples, Tirupati and all.
Yeah.
There, they push us.
Mm-hmm.
So, I was probably during my childhood also, I had this contradictory thinking. My parents were, we went to a temple.
Mm-hmm.
And there I didn't want to enter because there was all like, everybody were pushing. I felt like, what's the need to go inside?
You mean not the physical push, right? Just a push that you have to worship God, something like that.
No, the physical.
Physical push, oh, okay.
So, I stood out and my parents were very upset with me.
Yeah.
You know, all that. So, I really went.
Yes, that's nice. Your name again, Mataji? Swapnagaru. Yes, thank you. There is another Swapnagaru here somewhere. Yes. Yes. Anybody else? Does God exist? See, I'll tell you what. If today you're not going to challenge me, this might be your last opportunity. I want you to prove me that God doesn't exist before you go. And I will prove that God exists before you go. Anybody else? Yeah.
I believe that is an excellent concept made by our ancestors to keep the human race in discipline. Otherwise,
discipline.
By now, we would have extinct.
Like animals, you would have become like animals.
Our minds are very divided.
Yes.
This is a concept that has been developed.
Yeah. Wonderful. Yeah. That's a very sincere. Even I used to think the same way. There is nothing wrong in it. Yes, that's how. That's one way of looking at God. Yes, there is one hand there. Sorry, Mishra Prabhu. Mishra Prabhu is an artificial intelligence, very senior trainer. He has his own company. He travels around the world and sometimes he spares his time here. I'm very grateful he's running with a mic. Thank you, Prabhuji. Yes, Madhuji. Yeah.
Like she said, I also have a very bad feelings about going to crowded places.
Yes.
Temples are crowded and
yes.
I have been born and brought up in Puri.
Yes.
It's very crowded.
Puri, Hare Krishna, out of all the places.
I don't like to go to the temple because of the crowd,
yeah.
Because of the behavior that they do in the temples. So is it really necessary that one has to visit the temples to feel God?
Yes, that's very nice question. Amazing. Yes, Prabhuji.
God exists, but right now the concept is slightly misconstrued by a few people who want to rule by the name of God.
Yeah, that's also true. It's also true. Yes, God exists, but they are being misrepresented by some people. Yes, it's also true. Any other thoughts? I can see one hand in the back. Yes, Prabhuji there. Oh, there is someone even behind. Okay. Hare Krishna. Yes, Prabhuji. Does God listen to our words? Yes. Yeah. I don't know whether I'll be able to answer that question in this session, but that answer is part of SSR. So don't worry, it'll come. Yes, Prabhuji.
I've heard, I think the two ladies
talking
about going to temple.
Yeah.
My belief is going to the temple is not to see the idol.
Yeah.
Going to the temple to see there is a power. So
yes.
When you have God, there is a pratishtha.
Yes.
Before they do pratishtha, they do a lot of chanting. And they give that idol to the power.
Prana pratishtha. Correct.
That power exists there.
Correct.
So because of that power, when you go near to that power,
yeah,
you also get some power from that power, super power.
You also get some power from the super power.
That is why we go to temple.
Yes. Yes. Very nice thought. Your good name, sir? Rajugar. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, so see, there are many reasons, right? I mean, I'm really appreciate you're making this session very interesting by putting out the questions, because we have been hesitant to ask our questions. I'll take one last one because we have to make progress.
Yeah, I believe in God.
Yes.
No doubt about it. But my only question is, like, do we really have to by heart Bhagavad Gita or the Sanskrit slokas? Or is it that he understands only Sanskrit?
No, no, no. That, God is not as brutal as CBSE or NCERT. Don't worry. You know, we don't need to by heart anything. We just need to understand. Bhavagrahi Janardhana. He is a Bhavagrahi.
We don't have to
learn
any slokas.
Learn, yes. By heart, no.
Okay.
By heart, no. Yeah. Let's move. Yeah, Prabhuji. I think he has a comment there.
See, the concept of belief in God is not there in Sanatana Dharma.
Yes.
It is not expected that we should believe in God. It's only the Abrahamic religions, they say we have to believe in God and all that.
Okay.
It is that in our Sanatana Dharma, we have to experience God. That is, we should feel the presence of God.
Yes.
Isn't it so?
Well, belief comes through experience, right? When do we start believing something? We experience it, then automatically we start believing it. So definitely experience is very much needed. But experience also comes through following the instructions and the sadhana given by God, right? So there is a whole process in Sanatana Dharma. Sanatana Dharma itself is a very big concept. You know, a lot of people don't know the meaning of Sanatana Dharma also. We use it. Sanatana, eternal duty. Dharma means duty, Sanatana means eternal. What is the eternal duty? Right? Eternal duty of fire is what? What is the eternal duty of fire? To produce heat. What is the eternal duty of sugar? Sweetness. It is eternal duty. There is no way that duty can change. Whatever you do, no way the duty can change. What is the eternal duty of water? Cleaning. Cleaning is the eternal duty of water. The moment, what is thirst? It's all blockages that you clean, it immediately becomes available. It's not like your body needs water. Body needs water, but it needs to be cleaned every time. You have to pass on that water so that all the limbs are again moving around in a nice way. Eternal duty of water is to be clean, and it is to be liquid. To clean, it should be liquid. If you make it into ice, doesn't mean that water has become ice. It's a temporary state. But an eternal dharma of water is to clean. Understand that. So what is the eternal dharma of soul? What is the Sanatana dharma of soul? Now understand what is the meaning of Sanatana dharma? Have you learned what is the meaning of Sanatana dharma? Eternal duty is the meaning of Sanatana dharma. What is the Sanatana dharma of a soul? I discussed in the last session. Right? In Srimad Bhagavatam is explained. What is it mentioned? Savai pumsam paro dharmo yato bhakti radokshaje. Ahoiteki aprahiyata yayatma suprasidati. Beautifully, Vyasdev is told clearly what is Sanatana dharma. Sanatana dharma is to first understand who is the supreme. Who is the supreme here? Chandrasekhar Rao. Nonsense. Only for Telangana is. Who is above him? Who is above him? Narendra Modi. Nonsense. At country level. Next, Asia, continent level. There is nobody. Who is at the planet level? I don't know. Who is at the universe level? Maybe, okay. Who is at the whole manifestation level? Durga. Yes, that's right. But who is above her? Who is above her? Who is above Durga? Who is telling that I am controlling Durga? Right? So you have to go, you have to keep going up and up and up and up and in the scriptures. Finally find out, first of all, who is the supreme. That is the first duty of a soul. First find out who is the supreme. Next, parodharma is to serve that supreme. That is in bhakti. Bhakti means love. And how you are supposed to serve? Uninterruptedly and unmotivatedly. Ahoitaki aprahiyata. If you do these three things, finding the supreme person and then serving him in the mood of bhakti with love, and serving him uninterruptedly and unmotivatedly, then you will experience yayatma suprasidati. You will experience that happiness. So this is the Sanatana Dharma explained by the Vedic scriptures for a soul. Right? I got a little detract from does God exist? But since Prabhuji used the word Sanatana Dharma, I want everybody to understand that we are using these words called Dharma, Karma, Sanatana, Varnashrama, but we should understand the core concept sitting behind this. So next time you use Sanatana Dharma, you should know it's the eternal duty of a certain entity that we are attaching that Sanatana Dharma to. Right? But we'll discuss that, Prabhuji. As we go forward, we'll get more light on that. Yeah. Is it relevant to what we're discussing or different question? Okay. Go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah. Srinivas Prabhu. I want to know that, like,
yeah.
What is the difference between Sakara Brahma and Nirakara?
What is it?
Sakara Brahma and
Sakara Brahma, Nirakara Brahma. Yeah.
Yeah, formless.
Formless God and form God with a form.
Like, you know, until I hear about formless God, I was very clear that God exists.
Yes.
And I had understanding of God. But the moment knowledge came in,
correct.
My devotion is like for a
Yes. Can you keep a little closer?
Yeah. I mean, like, until I hear some more knowledge, like,
yeah.
I was okay, you know, doing my devotional path.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Maybe, like, hearing so many sources. So I heard about, like, you yourself is God. Like,
yeah, yeah.
All those concepts, like,
somebody told he's God.
So I'll be confused now. So finally, my question is, like, whether we have to reach God or, like, we have to remove something to know that we are already part of God.
Where you have to reach God or just realize that we are part of God? Very good question. Prabhuji, it's a very advanced question. I have an answer, but I don't think I should give that answer right now, because maybe you are ready, but others, I don't know at what level of consciousness they are. But be rest assured that this question will be answered. In 8th session, which is Who is God, is a very elaborate session which every Indian especially should attend. Right? Then we will understand how we can talk about Nirakara Brahman, Sakara Brahman, Nirguna, Nirakara, those whole words, how to apply that. Yes, Prabhuji.
Sir, we also come across the concept that there is a Parabrahman.
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 Yes.
That means something that is super to Brahma. Now,
yeah.
We are all talking about Akar, Nirakar, Brahma.
Correct.
What does this Parabrahman mean? Who would be above that?
Ah, very nice. Beautiful. Your name again, Prabhu. Sorry, I forgot last
name. Naman.
Naman, Naman, Prabhu. Yes. I will answer that, Prabhuji. Again, be rest assured that answer will come. I don't want to deviate into that whole topic of Brahman and Parabrahman. It's a very technical topic, but I don't think we are ready for it right now. Right? It's part of 8th session again. 8th session, I'll at least quote 10 verses directly from scriptures which explain the difference between Brahman, Parabrahman and so forth. Yeah, go ahead.
My question is,
yeah.
Is God just like us, like you said earlier?
Yeah. Yes.
So if God is just like us, what is the difference between us
and God? Wonderful. Your name, please?
Shaurya Ranjan.
Shaurya Ranjan. Beautiful question, isn't it? Why God? Is he God just like us? Does he also feel hunger? Does he also feel sleep? Right? Does God exist and is going further down? Yeah. I'll answer that question as we go forward. Yes, Madhuri.
Again, see, I'm already with this doubt.
Yeah. Go ahead, Sapna Madhuri. Yeah. Yeah. Correct.
To turn in this direction, and then you need to put on this one. So I am completely not okay with that.
Correct.
And I have proper resistance for that.
Correct.
Now, when you have also asked us to skip the bead, the Krishna bead, and you know this finger.
Correct.
And all, so it is giving me the same
similar feeling.
Huh.
Why am I doing what I'm doing?
Yeah. Exactly.
So for now, I'll say go ahead with Krishna bead. No problem. Right?
So
because when I'll take you to a level of consciousness, then you automatically will not skip it. I mean, will not roll over it. That's okay. And remember one thing, because you're skipping over Krishna, but doesn't mean Krishna will become angry on you.
Yeah, exactly.
Absolutely no.
Mm-hmm.
God is above any such, you know, rituals. When Shabari was feeding Ram, you know how she was feeding? She was biting it, tasting it, and then giving it to Ram. Lord Brahma is sitting and understanding that to perform yajna to Vishnu, everything has to be so clean and so nicely kept. And this lady is biting and giving directly to the Supreme Lord, that you eat it. And what is Lord Ram saying? This is the tastiest bear I had in my life. And Lakshmana is bewildered. Kya bol raha mera bhai? You know. So, to understand God and His love, first of all, we should remove fear of God. God is not sitting there to punish us. Never. Never He would want to punish us.
Mm-hmm. You know, when it is attached,
mm-hmm.
then I am away from that.
Yes.
You know, I better be away from that.
Better be away only. Till you understand. See, I'll tell you, there is a meaning for everything, but unfortunately we are not introduced to it. Did you come in the previous sessions?
No, I didn't.
Okay, so you should listen to the previous session completely.
I gave
several examples, okay, of how we were doing things without being aware of those things, right? So it's very important for us to know why we do what we do. And then we will actually automatically start doing it. Like for example, when a child is born, you know, you should put the child between two legs, ulta, upside down and do massage. Hardly, barely 5-year-old infant is being put outside. Have you seen that? Your grandma is doing it. Did you get scared? Oh my God, what will happen to my child? right? But that is the massage which gives them the kind of muscles and kind of strength for the rest of their life. You know, that is the way when it is properly done. So we may not know, and we may not know how to do it also, but they also can't explain us properly because they have seen their mothers doing it, they are doing it themselves. But if you go to a proper acupuncture specialist who is really having some Ayurveda touch also, then he will explain which limb of the body is triggering what in that child. In the same way, your mother has asked you to do certain thing, but she never explained why. Yeah. And because she did not explain why, you might even think it's useless. But actually it's useful. But at this point, I will not explain all that. Because first I want you to elevate your consciousness to faith on God. Then we will get, I'm not telling at the end of 12 sessions, we all will hold a diya and rotate. That's not the goal. Definitely that's not, you will not become like that. But you will become very intelligent to differentiate what is important and what is not. See rituals, how they are formed? Once there was a yajna going on, and in that yajna, they had to put lot of milk inside the yajna, right? And they kept lot of milk there, and a cat was coming again and again and drinking that milk. This yajna was going on thousands of years ago. And then they realized this cat has become a big nuisance, it is disturbing the minds of brahmanas, so tie that cat, you know, to the side. So the next time the cat came, they tied it to the side. So every time they are doing the yajna, that cat is coming and they are tying it to the side. The same yajna continued, and after 800 years, maybe 200 years back, when the yajna is being done, there is actually no cat, but they got a cat and tied it beside. So the point is cat needed for that yajna? No. Why was it done at that time? Nobody told. But now cat has to sit there. You know? So we should have some common sense, you know. We should ask, bhaiya, billi ka iske saath kya sambandh hai? Nahi nahi, aisa nahi bolte, chup beta. So billi ko lekar band ho. Then you should question, you know, why? Then we are sitting here, na? These sessions are for that purpose only. We can clarify a lot of these things. Remove the unnecessary things, include the most necessary things. And I'll tell you, question with respect, because actually there is a meaning. There are few things that are unnecessary which have come like these cats, right, which we will remove over a period of time. But keep the faith that what our ancestors and the great acharyas have left has a lot of meaning behind it. They're all templates to love God. Right? The templates, when you follow over a period of time, you'll capture right data, you'll have full information, and you'll get full bhakti. They are like proven templates. When a boy meets a girl, he has to give a rose flower. If he gives a big watermelon, it will not work. You know, it's a different thing. So the template proven over a period of time, right? So in the same way, there are some templates that we use even in bhakti, which are time proven. When you execute the template over a period of time, with a proper explanation of course, you will see transformation in your consciousness. But problem is, we are only exposed to templates, the reason is missing, right? The reason is missing and the goal is completely missing. So you don't know why we are doing what, right? There is ghanta in a temple, there is one place to sit, nice floor, there is the deity inside the garbhagudi, they are saying not to enter. Why I should not enter? I don't know, right? Only he has to come out. Why is coming out? Why can't he stand inside only? I don't know. Why is asking for gotra only? Why not my name right now? I can tell my name, right? Swapna. No, what is your gotram? Why gotram? Why only name is not enough? You can question. But he has to give an answer also. There is a good reason for that. Right? So, as we go forward, we will get answers to a lot of these questions. And the science of self-realization is a course created specifically for removing these layers so we can slowly transcend to the next level where we can read Bhagavad Gita at some point. Right? So, let's go forward and we'll take more questions as we go forward. Okay? Okay, so adding to your questions, do we have these questions? So many rituals, what is the use? Just focus on God. You just told it, right? So I made it, I already know because I am the most, when I attended this session in Boston, you know, like more than a decade ago, I am trying to finish this session in how much time? 2 hours. I made sure the speaker spoke about it for 6 months. Okay, so I have tortured people a lot in this session, right? So don't worry. Yeah, so, but we should ask these questions. Don't accept anything whimsically. That is the reason we are sitting here, na? Because we have not asked, nobody has answered. Now we have faith in God or no God or some energy or like Prabhuji asked, what is God first of all? You know, why should I even accept? Right? So that is very important question. We should get to that point. Do people who are afraid go to temples? Yes. Most of the time they are afraid. Aaj ye saal mein nahi gaya toh pata nahi kya hoga. You know, let me go and figure it out. Is it cowardly for anyone to go to God when they are worried? Like when they are worried, only when he is worried he go to the temple. That's why you are a coward, you know, you don't have your own self power or anything. People comment like that, isn't it? Are there two gods? One who created us and one whom we created? Right? Are there two gods? Right? Like, yeah, some of you even questioned on this level. Is God who made us completely unknowable to us? Fundamental question. Is God trying to be unknowable? Meaning, He does not want us to know Him. He is hiding somewhere. And He is completely creating a whole illusion in front of us that He should not be accessible. Is that what it is? If your child asks this question, do we have an answer? Is religion made by God-man or by God Himself? Did God create the religion or God-man created the religion? And what is religion, first of all? What is the meaning of religion? Why are we not born with religion stamped on us? There is a movie called PK which brought these questions out. Right? Beautiful movie called PK. What is the problem with PK? How many liked the movie PK? Wonderful. Even I liked that movie. But one thing I did not like is it only put the questions. It never answered the questions. They made a nice business out of putting questions, creating atheists into perfect atheists, but then they never answered. Why don't you answer? Then the PK is complete, isn't it? You put a question, you have to answer that question also. So we are a result of PK movie also, you know. We are trying to answer everything that. Why do different religions have different rituals? One religion says like this, one religion says like this, one says like this, one says like this, one says like this. What is this? Is this some kind of a gymnastics exercise or what, you know? You know, there should be a reason why we are doing this, that, isn't it? Yeah. Are different religions like different companies with their gods as different products? This my, you know, somebody who is very close to me asked me, so I put that question there. Does a stone smeared with colored powder become God? You see a stone somewhere, start kumkuma and put some, you know, that, what is that, turmeric, and keep three flowers, and suddenly next day you see three women are rotating around it. Right? And suddenly it becomes God. Is that the way it works? Is that God so cheap that we can just bring any stone and make Him into God? Why God can hear our prayers? When God can hear our prayers everywhere, what is the need to go to a temple? Right? Is that a fundamental question? You can hear everywhere. Now, what is the need to go to a temple? Can we not ask questions on faith openly? Why do some people become offended on asking questions? If I make you sit here and say, इस संतोषी माँ गॉड प्रभु जी डोंट गेट पर्सनल देखो तुमको जो करना है तुम करो इतना लेवल पे मत जाओ ऊपर ऊपर बात करो वाई व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम इफ यू आर सो फेथफुल टुवर्ड्स गॉड व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम इन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट दैट गॉड टुडे वी आर अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ नॉट डिस्कसिंग थिंग्स ओपनली वी आर वर्शिपिंग कैरेक्टर्स हु आर नॉट इवन एग्जिस्टिंग इन स्क्रिप्चर्स विथ आर ओन इमेजिनेशंस यू आर डिक्लेरिंग देम एज गॉड ऑल्सो गॉडेसेस ऑल्सो For example, Santoshima. How many did Santoshi Vrata here? I also did. I mean, my aunt, she does. You know where did Santoshima come from? It has come from Gulshan Kumar's T-Series company. He made a movie called Santoshima. There is no scriptural authentication called Santoshima. And later on, the producer shouted that, Baba, stop this. This was not meant to be made into temples. And already temples are opened. There is one in Koti also. Santoshi Maa Ki Jai. Bhajans have come. Anuradha Potwal has made T-series cassettes. Everybody is singing Santoshi Maa. And everybody is singing Santoshi Maa also. There is no Santoshi Maa. 3.3 crore demigod, there is no Santoshi Maa. How many has guts to clear his doubts like this? And why is it such a big problem to clear your doubts? Why can't we learn from scriptures what the truth is? Why can't we authentically clear off what unnecessary rituals are? I'm sorry. If somebody was very attached to Santoshima. But now is the time you had to get that message. I also got that message like that. Right? So many other messages will come, which will shake the ground. But don't fall. Stay still, you know. There is somebody called God. We don't want to accept that has come to us in different ways. Purpose of religion is to remove such misconceptions from our life. Purpose of SSR, as I told last week, is not to entertain you. To tell you what is the truth. Whether you accept it, like it, come next time, not come, doesn't matter. Right? So that, it matters because you are giving me service. I will really feel sad that, you know, I could not serve somebody properly. But I'll pray that God will give you the strength to accept the truth in the right spirit. We are not here for rituals. Why does God not respond to my our prayers? Who asked that question, Samna? Does God respond to prayers? Somebody asked here. I can't remember. Yeah. Yeah? Yeah. So, does he even respond to my prayer? I have been praying for such a long time. Your child might ask, Papa, I prayed, still I got 4 out of 30 only. What will your response be? Pat, you'll give one. Prayer to prayer, pada nahi pada. Isn't it? You have to study also. Yes, God helps the one who wants to help himself. Right? So there is a whole funda. So does he even respond to our prayers? Yes, he does. But if your child is asking these questions and you're not able to answer these questions, then you are nothing but atheist in the guise of theist. Right? You are wearing all the tilak, you are wearing this kadiyam, you are wearing this mala, you are doing this kanti, you know, you are going to temple, but actually you are pakka hardcore atheist only. You don't know the answers of all these questions. Without knowing answers to all these questions, how can you claim that you are theist? Well, sometimes somebody has to challenge you on this. Because God is not a sentiment for you or me. Does he exist or not? Is very, very important fundamental question that we have to be convinced before we go forward. You follow me? I don't want this session to, you know, whimsically tell you that it exists. If you don't accept him, you'll go to Naraka Loka or, you know, something will happen. You know, all that is not a way to explain about God. No Vedic scripture talks like that. Wonderful aspect of Vedic scriptures that I liked. You know, I've been a hardcore atheist myself. Never allowed anybody to tell me who is God or, you know, any religious thing. But when I sat with somebody who was educated, just like me, I'm a CA, MBA myself. I have done my part in life. But when somebody explained me scientifically, one by one, question, answer, question, answer, question, answer, I told him, if you answer all my questions, I'll surrender. He answered all my questions. I surrendered. I have to surrender. After answering all the questions also, if I'm not surrendering, that means actually I have no intention to get answers. Is it not? Yes. All of you ask all your questions. We are making note of it. We will answer every single question when the 12 sessions get over. You will not have any single question answered, unanswered. Yes, there might be a possibility that the answer may not be completely convincing to you, because some answers take some time and maturity to get totally convincing, and that is possible. But you will get convinced at a point of time. Right? So, if you don't have answers for all these questions, so let us agree that we are atheists, and today is our first session to know, understand, does God exist? Right? And if you already know the answers to these questions, then why don't we appreciate it by understanding more answers, right? More ways of looking at the same thing. Everything I like is either illegal, immoral, fattening, expensing, or impossible. Right? Every time I want to enjoy something, they'll say, hey, God doesn't like it, don't do it. You know, what is this? You know, people say these things about God, right? See, this session that of does God exist, it's very easy to finish it in half an hour. But first I want to grill the atheist out of all of you. Literally pull that person and make him sit in your friend chair. Because unless that disease comes out, I cannot give the cure. But first I want to pull out the whole way we are bombarded to think like an atheist, even though we are born in a country where God himself has appeared. Right? So let's spend some time. There is no God. Now stop worrying and enjoy your life. Beautiful mantra, isn't it? Right? You can follow this mantra anytime. Were we forced to accept God? Who told that? She told. You told, right? You're forced to accept God. Yes, of course. Forced to pray. You know, forced to pray. God's chosen under pressure. Did we really believe in the existence of God? Pray, kid, or God will have you killed. You know, at that level things have gone. Have we really accepted God as with love? How many here love Venkateshwar Swami? Please lift your hand. Love. What is the basis of that love? Because he looks good? He's sitting 800 feet on the top? Or his laddu is good? What is the basis of that love? There should be a strong base, Prabhuji. Yes.
He looks good.
Yes, if I show somebody better than him, will you change? Is it completely only based on his looks? Yes, Radha Krishna Prabhu, right?
Ramakrishna
Prabhu, yes, Prabhuji. Sorry.
It's because the experiences people have shared that you pray him, you wish is fulfilled.
Yes.
The Mohan.
So transaction is done.
Transaction
is done. You know, I opened my business, Venkata Venkatesh Swami, I told I'll give 50%, he gave me 70%. So I gave him back 50% with 5% bonus. So he exists. Isn't it? Transactional God. That is how I believe God exists or not. Yes. But unfortunately, that is not going to be lasting for too long. our faith on God is filled with fear because we have been forced to accept God. How many accept this? At some level, we should accept this. You know, that actually I'm fearful that maybe if he's there, you know, like one of my friends, he was doing Satyanavratam, sorry, Gropravesham. And me and him were very close friends in the college times. Anybody who used to put Tilak and come to the office, to the school, we used to make fun of him. You know, this old fashioned fellow. We used to make fun of him. Completely ridicule anybody who is religious. Me and my friend. And after many years, you know, thankfully God gave me some enlightenment, even though I'm not qualified. But my friend, I never knew that he's enlightened or anything, but suddenly he called. He bought a flat in Hyderabad for 75 lakhs. I said, wow, that's nice. Then he told, I'm doing Gropravesham, please come. I was shocked. Hare, this fellow never believed in God. Why is he doing Gropravesham? Gropravesham is a ritual, right? I mean, like, the whole bringing of auspiciousness and all that. If you don't believe in God, why are you doing Gropravesham? Then out of that inquisitiveness, I applied leave and went to his Gropravesham. I want to see this fellow. After many years, I'm meeting him. So then I saw he's sitting with pura banyan nikalke, you know, that whole nama mom lagake, sitting with his wife, children. I went inside, I was looking, kya ho gaya tere ko? I'll talk to you later. Let me finish this, you know. He was finishing it. You know, sitting and waiting, let me see what happens after. 75 lakhs, you know, flat he bought and he's doing this whole Gropravesham. And then after the Gropravesham, I went to him and said, bol re, kya hua? We both, you know, right, what we used to be. I'll tell my story, how I came towards God. But I can't believe that you have come towards God. What is going on? You know what he told? I really love my friend. He told a sincere answer. He told, boss, 75 lakshal betti flat unna. Aa devudu antu odu unte santosha padtho 2000 padesina ipo. Telugu samjhmein aaya. 75 lakhs laga ke flat kharida. Agar ek bhagwan hai 2000 dal diya khush ho jayega. Right? Gropravesham kar diya, char nariyal phod diya. ब्राह्मण आया कुछ कुछ ब्रह्म भ्रम बोल के चला गया, खत्म हो गया. वो अगर भगवान है तो कुछ हो गया, अगर नहीं है तो फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. दो ही तो हजार गया, 2000 लेफ्ट, राइट. सो दैट इज अ सिंसियर आंसर. आर वी डूइंग विथ फियर और आर वी डूइंग एज अ रिचुअल? बिकॉज इफ यू एंटर अ हाउस एंड पीपल कम, ग्रोप्रवेशन कब है? बुलाया नहीं मेरे को, किया ही नहीं. अरे ऐसे कैसे नहीं किया ग्रोप्रवेशन? यस प्रो जी, बोथ. Both. He did it as a ritual because his parents told you cannot enter the house without doing it. And second, he felt if there is a God, let him be satisfied.
Then it is not fear, no. If it is there, then he will be.
Yeah, if there is a God, let him be satisfied. But if there is God, then he'll be satisfied. That means I'll not get affected. You know, I'll not get affected. This house will remain still because if there is a God, he'll take care of it.
Giving a benefit of doubt to the God, it is not fear, not ritual.
But why is the benefit of doubt? Not open mind. Oh. Okay, you can look at it like that also. If you want to look at it like that, you can look like that also. Yeah, yeah. Fear or open mind, whichever way you look at it. See, many of us do a lot of things. Yeah. Let's pass it on. Yes, madam. Yes. There can be many reasons, right? I mean, fear, open mind, like Prabhuji is saying, you can have many reasons to do what you are doing. But is it really faith in God? Definitely not. He made it very clear to me. I know him for 20 years. He told very clearly, I am the same person, but I am doing it because my father will be happy. My neighbors will be happy. I have done Gropavesham, right? And if there is a God, he will be satisfied. Because who knows, if he is there, tomorrow, if I find out that he is there and I have not respected him, I don't know what he'll do to me, right? There is agarbatti that I'm moving in my house. There are 20 photographs. This amma, this baba, this kaka, this nana, they're going on. Suddenly I miss somebody. Immediate amma, I forgot this. Why? Out of respect? Or one photo is not there. How can that photo not be? Immediately go to, you know, Raniganj, get that photo. Put it there, you know, that person is there. And so we go to somebody else's house. And a new photo is there. New amma has come, new market. This amma is doing, I'll also get one photo, keep it there. Or your friend gifted, and because he has gifted, he believes in her, you also have to give, because who knows, she might work. I should not disrespect anybody. I want to be good with everybody. I should not disrespect everybody. So everybody are in my altar at the same level. That is called sarve jana, no, sarve bhagavan sukhina bhavantu. Isn't it? no scientific understanding, no proper guidance. And we are a product of fear or open mind, whatever you call. Next. Were our questions answered? What was the answer when the child asked the question? Mama, please tell me, does God exist? Child is asking, Mom, why did God let my friend Johnny die? What is the mom's answer? No one knows but God. It's not for us to understand. Simple. How many have got such an answer? You got such an answer, right? Beautiful answer. So here, in modern education system, they have come to a point where they say, we let them come to their own conclusions because we want them to grow and exercise their faculties of logic and reason. We give them choice, we empower them. We don't want to educate our children God exists or not. They will only decide when they grow up. What they'll decide? People who are doing so much tapasya to understand God, following the process, are still going through the austerity and trying to reach God. Without doing anything, without following any process, no scriptural evidence, no scriptural training, I will find out, figure it out myself. Well, you should be open-minded. It should not be, mind should not be so open that brain falls out. Right? You should get educated. Have we all gone to a college or no? Okay, forget about us. Will you join your children in a school or no? Why? Open-minded. Children are open-minded. Why you want them to go to school? Children are open. I am open-minded. My children also should be open-minded. What is the problem? Huh? Anybody here who want their children to be open-minded, not sending to school? Why? When you have an open mind, why are you sending your children to school? Because it's very easy to say open mind, open mind, open mind. We actually don't believe in open mind. We know that we all need guidance. We all need guidance. When it comes to God, Prabhu, open-minded experience mangta hai. You know, experience chahiye. But when it comes to other, marks lanega, you know, what is this? Go to the right institution, this certificate, that palana, everything has to happen. But when it comes to God, no guru needed, no open mind. Right? What is the result of that? Open mind? We don't know whom we are following, we don't know whom we are worshipping, we don't know if prayers are actually going up, we don't know if the process is working or not. We don't know. I'm not saying it's not, I'm saying we don't know. We don't know. That is the problem today, isn't it? Yeah. So our questions are not answered. Look at this beautiful book. It's a bestseller book. Growing Up Godless, A Parent's Guide to Raising Children Without Religion. And thousands of people are buying this. I want to raise my children without religion. Scientific way of living, right? Scientific means God should not be there. You think God doesn't have a science behind it? I'll ask a simple question, answer. Why is water in an ocean salty? I want to answer. Why is water in an ocean salty? If there is a God, he should have simply made sweet water, right? Pura pani ka problem theek ho jata. Hai ki nahi? Why only river water is salty? Sweet. Why not water in the ocean is salty? Sweet. Seven oceans are there. No water problem, no manjira problem, no Kaveri dispute. Ek canal banao, Arabian Sea se Hyderabad tak, you will get unlimited water. Why water in an ocean is salty? Please apply your open minds. Come up with an answer. Science. This is science. You are saying God doesn't have a science. I am asking a fundamental question. How many have gone to a beach? Touch the water in your tongue. Is it salty?
Yes.
Okay, it's proven it's salty. So one thing is done. Tell me now, why is it salty? If God has a logic, it should be logical. Why is it salty?
Because of salt.
Because of salt, it is salty.
What is
it? No, I am asking, why is it salty? Why not sweet?
I don't know.
That's what I am asking. I will tell you why it is salty. That's why I am asking. I will tell Prabhuji. I will tell what is that answer. See, there is a reason for everything. We don't know doesn't mean it doesn't have a reason. There is a reason. And Vedic scriptures are explaining, why is it salty? Should I tell? In the interest of time. Somebody is also looking at clock. Aaj ka session time pe hoga, nahi hoga. Let me tell the answer. When it is salty, the water is preserved very nicely. When you have to preserve something, you have to put salt in it. That is the nature of salt. It can be easily preserved. And when it is salt in the water, it evaporates very easily. Tomorrow you take two bowls of water, put salt in one, don't put salt in one, keep it in the sun. The one with salt will evaporate very fast. The way the whole nature is created by Lord, God, the Creator Himself, is so beautiful that when the fresh water is needed, He is preserving the water in a different place. He transports it through evaporation. A beautiful invisible aeroplane and a big tanker is moving through which even an aeroplane can go. Nothing will touch. And it goes to the right location where it is needed or where that devata is more satisfied. He will shower it there and it is purely filtered. Science. Does it sound scientific? Can you prepare anything like this? Can a scientist prepare a cloud which travels from here to there, carries all the water? One cloud can flood the entire city. Entire Bombay was flooded by one cloud. Not more than one cloud. One cloud. Done. Entire city. Chennai was flooded by one cloud. Maybe two clouds. You know, that is the power and that is the way the environment is designed. Every single thing has a scientific logic. If we have vision and ears and true inquisitiveness without a challenging nature, the one who challenges will never get knowledge. He should inquire with submissiveness. Inquire with submissiveness. Submissive inquiry will provide knowledge. Vedas are explaining. Right? There was one person, he was very thirsty, he was walking and he was very thirsty. So he was looking around, he saw a watermelon. He broke that watermelon, he ate the watermelon. Juice went into his mouth, right? He said, very nice. Then he was looking at the watermelon plant. He was saying, what kind of a god is he? Irrational fellow. Such a big fruit, such a thin tree. Creeper. If I was God, I'll make a big tree for big fruits. Right? And then he was very tired. He went and slept under a big tree. And suddenly one nut fell on his head. Top bulge. He got up. Hey, what is this? Who is there? Right? And then he thanked God. Bach gaya main. Because it would have been a watermelon, my head would have smashed by now. Such a big tree, such a small fruit still works. So don't try to put your rationale to understand God. To understand His creation, you need humility and humbleness. Then you'll understand why things are working in a certain way, why we are the way we are. When we all took birth, did we come out like spare parts, one hand here, one leg here, one head there, and your mother and father fitted them in right direction? We all came ready-made, fully finished products out of the supply chain. It's coming out like this, isn't it? And everything is functioning, everything is growing. It's miraculous, right? So don't put your logics with respectfulness. Plead to God that, God, I want to understand, do you exist? Please provide me this knowledge. And you will get the answers. You will get the answers. But unfortunately, when the answers are not given, people write books like that I want to raise children without religion. I want to raise children godless. That is not an answer. If you did not understand your questions at one place, you go to another place. Even now I'm telling you, after 12 sessions, if your questions are not answered, if any one of your questions are not answered, the conclusion is not that God doesn't exist. You go to a better person than me. That should be your mood. Well, I want to get the answer. I want to get the answer. Hook or crook, whichever way. If not here, I'll go to Islam. If not Islam, I'll go to Christianity. If not Christianity, I'll go to Buddhism. Somewhere, I have to find my answer. Until I get a convincing answer, until I feel that I'm satisfied, we should never stop the quest. That should be the thirst. With humility. Not with challenging nature. Right? What is science telling us today? In order to explain about God, we have to smash science also. Because unfortunately, science is making us believe that God doesn't exist. Look at this picture. I found it in internet. I didn't make it. Children don't have legs. Science also is seeing them the same way. Religion is also seeing the same way. Science is creating a leg to fit into those children. Those children are running nicely. Religion is asking them to pray and they are still without legs. See how faith is being broken? How people are trying to propagate atheism, that, you know, I am able to do things which God is not able to do. One person told a devotee that, you know, what your God is doing, you're living like a beggar. You know, you don't have any money. What your God is doing for you? He said, my God is taking care of me, no problem. And he said, let us see what God will do for you. and that person did not have food for many days. He was living in the house. And one day, this person felt, now I have proven that God doesn't exist. So he took a lot of food and went to his door and knocked on his door and gave the food. They said, see, now you understand? Actually, unless we work, unless I give you food, God is not giving. He said, no, God is still giving me food. God is so great that even a demon will bring food to my doorsteps. He'll make him bring, right? So don't look at the way things are happening for you. There is a whole chain happening in between, behind, right? We should have faith to see those things. But we are not going to just go by faith. We'll deal it scientifically. I believe in higher powers, but not God. Have you heard this? Yes, of course. I heard from that side. Mother, you told. I believe in some power. Some electricity, some transformer is there. You know, maybe it is God, but it is working. And maybe it is a made-up God, kind of a story that makes me live a meaningful or a peaceful life. Duryodhana was smashed by Bhima, so I better not be a Duryodhana. Better be a proper person. Out of fear only, right? Puranas are all stories made to fear me so that I can submit to some person who doesn't may or may not exist. I don't know if Rama exists or not. But let me try to be a Hanuman, because if he exists, I'm in trouble. Right? We are all born atheists until someone starts telling us lies. Right? This beautiful thing I found. Anyway, we can go forward. Source of wisdom for modern society. Okay, from where all did you understand who is God? And how is God and God's things? How did you understand? Any one of you? Where all did you get the knowledge of God till now? Parents. More than that, YouTube. Right? More than that, serials. Do you know these characters? Rama and Sita in Ramanand Sagar Ramayana, Krishna in B.R. Chopra Ramayana, Mahabharat, Nagarjuna in Annamaya, right? Krishna. Sorry. Are you okay, sir? Okay. Yeah. No, if you don't mind, just put two chairs. I do that always. No, just put two chairs, one on each other. Yeah, use that, sir. Sorry. I'm so sorry. Are you hurt? It happened to me in this hall, so I can share your pain. Please settle down. Yeah, that's the way. Actually, these plastic chairs, now after a period of time, they lose their durability. They'll break. They'll start breaking apart. Yeah. So you know all these characters that you see here? How many have seen all this? Did they give you wisdom? But I'll tell you, they never gave you faith. You know why? You know why they never gave you faith? Wisdom is one side, but they never gave you faith. Because of this nonsense. The same characters who are playing such godly roles are doing nonsense on the screen also. How will you gain faith? Right? I don't want to elaborate. And a beautiful movie called PK will come there. Oh my God, PK will come there and make lots and lots of money out of it. Just questioning our atheism, saying that if God is small murti, you'll get small benefit. If God is big murti, you'll get big benefit. Is that what it is? And person atheist sitting, are acha bola re, acha bola. Ye movie fir se doston ko bhi bolunga main. They also should comment see. That is a question mark he left. Did he give the answer? He told, in such kind of movies they tell, why to serve God? Why to put so much money on Abhishekam? Give it to poor people. They will drink, na? They will eat, na? Immediately, are acha bola re answer. That is what, even I had this question. Acha bola. Do you know the answer for that question? Has anybody given the answer for that question? Is there an answer for that question? Did PK give the answer for that question? No. But PK made millions of rupees. How much did they make? 1,000 crores they made from PK movie. Okay, let me answer this one question. Why we should feed poor people? Why to put all that money on God's worship? What will come out of God's worship? Why to put all that Abhishekam, this juice, that juice, Nariyal Kapani, honey, ghee, all on God, some rock? What is the use? Let me answer. Have you seen Abhishekam happening in a temple anytime? What happens after the Abhishekam is complete? What happens to all those juices? It is called as Charanamrita. Charana Amrita. And is it given to you or it is hidden in a museum? It is given to every single person who comes to the temple. That they should taste what has touched the Lord. Right? So nothing is. What happens to all those flowers which are put in a temple as garlands? Is that not waste of flowers? Instead you can garland yourself and take a selfie. Why to garland that God who may or may not exist? Well, the garlands afterwards are used as manure for plants to produce more flowers. Everything, at least they are supposed to be used. Lot of temples are not following it, unfortunately. So people are losing faith. Maybe they are not using it for the right purpose. Let me ask a fundamental question to all of you, even if it hurts your ego. How many buy branded clothes here? Why buy branded? Buy it in Koti, na? Use that money for feeding poor? What is the problem? Why we have to buy cosmetics? If your face is beautiful, anyway beautiful, why you have to beautify it? Take that money and feed the poor, na? Why you want a big branded car? Go in a 800, it is also going on the same road. It also has AC. Why you want a big Audi car? Use that money for feeding poor, na? Why you want a big touch screen mobile phone changing every 6 months? 20,000 rupees you are wasting. You can feed at least 200 children every month with that money. Why you want a branded phone? Use that money to feed poor, na? Prabhuji, bahut ho gaya. Aisa question mat pucho. Bhagwan ko nahi jane ka, apne ko chahiye. I want it. God? No. This is nonsense. This is what is going on. Why? What is your problem? You don't have faith in God. Somebody has faith in God. He is trying to serve in his own way. He has faith. I am trying to water the root so all the leaves will be green. I am trying to pray to the Creator so the whole creation will be happy. That is my faith. Who are you to question it? If you want to feed the poor, stop using branded clothes and branded cars. Go out and serve the poor. No, Prabhuji, only when tsunami comes, I want a picture. I'll go, then only I'll put clothes. Then only I'll give my clothes for donation. Right? One Azim Premji gave 5,000 crores in charity, it came in all the papers. Tirumala Devasthanam is feeding more than 5 lakh meals in a single day. Has it come in papers? How many here have eaten Dharma? Bhojan, Dharmasthala Bhojanam in Tirumala. Tell me the quality. Is it better than your house or lesser than your house? Has it come in papers? How many temples are feeding free food every single day? Authorized or not, whatever temple it is. So many. Prashadam is available. No beggar needs to be given a penny. They can go and eat in a temple. Every temple is open. In ISKCON society, 13 lakh plates of prashadam is distributed every single day. Around the world, free. You've seen that, Akshay Patra outside, 5 rupees a plate. Will you supply in your house? Religion is actually feeding people. Don't think that religion is not. We are just not publicizing. We don't want to publicize because it's a service. I feel that satisfaction. Sarve jana sukino bhavantu happens when Madhava is happy. When Krishna is happy, automatically sarve jana sukino bhavantu happens. That is faith. But how movies like PK are challenging? Madhava seva. And Madhava seva is also Manava seva. That people are not understand. Atheist will say Madhava seva, Manava seva, Madhava seva. But a theist will say Madhava Seva is Manava Seva. Automatically it happens. A religious person will automatically give to the society. You don't need a special training. When I went to Srirangam, what is the place Ramanujacharya took birth? What was that place? Sri Perambatur. Me and my family, we visited. We don't eat outside food. We were like craving for good food. Everything is filled with onion and garlic. I don't eat onion and garlic. So what should I do? Where should I go? One family just called us into the house, cooked for us, gave us nice 7-course meal. We went to tears that day. It was a small Gurukul, Brahmana's family. We didn't even ask. They gave us nicely. They served us and they said, thank you very much for coming. And he's like, I want to give something for the ashram. Please don't. This is our seva. Who will do it? Go and stand outside Azim Premji's house, whether he'll allow you inside. I'm not challenging one person. I'm telling this is what is going on here. And by the way, the so-called PK movie, which made 1,000 crores of business, how many crores went for poor people? We are idiots to listen such kind of a philosophy and believe that they have done good by exposing religion. They have not exposed religion. They have exposed their ego. They have exposed their atheism. They flushed it on people. Every single question can be answered what they have challenged. There is a reason. We don't worship stones. We don't worship stones. If we worship stones, how are we walking on this stone right now? Is it not stone below our feet? Did I not walk and come here? Was I jumping like a deer? We don't worship stones. We worship God in that stone. And that murti is not made like Ganesh murti outside, like Bahubali Ganesh is outside. Ganesh with a bat, Ganesh with a tennis racket, Ganesh with somebody, Ganesh, you know, in this form, that form. We don't worship like that. That is cheap. When we worship Ganeshji, we know how he looks like. There is a shastra, there is an explanation of how God looks like. It's not created by humans. It is given. And there is a prana pratishta that is done. It is not just like, you know, keep something and start worshipping. That is whimsical. That is actual atheism. We don't believe in all that. Right? There is a whole science behind it. When you want to post your letter, what color box you put that letter into? Red color box. So can you create a red color box in your house and post into that? Can you do that? Rauji, can you do that? Anybody with an open mind to put your letter into a red color box, will it go to the destination? Why it will not go? Come on, be open-minded, boss. Be cool, you know, be dude, you know, be scientific. It's the same red box there, red box here. Why is it not going? Because it's not approved by the government. Simple. In the same way, when the government doesn't approve, when the acharyas and the Vaishnava sampradayas and the scriptures are not approving a deity to be a deity, it will not work. That is why Santoshima doesn't work. Simple. And there are many others. If I tell, you might beat me. But that's not the agenda. They will not work. You can be whimsical and we can be happy worshipping them. But they will not work. Because they are not approved. If a time pass is little, post box needs approval, what about God's murti? Doesn't it need approval? Doesn't it need a particular form? You can't make Krishna dancing with 20 gopis and say, he is a lusty boy, you know, he is like this. What kind of a God is he? Well, who are you to decide? First of all, who made that painting? Where is the approval for that? Where is the scripture which is explaining that this is how Krishna operates, this is how Rama operates, this is how Narasimha operates? You know, one American asked me, how come your God is, you know, tearing somebody apart and drinking his blood? That's what Lord Narasimha did, right? When he killed Hiranyakashipu. So what kind of a God is he? Yeah. So that has the answer. So I told him the entire Prahlad Leela. The seventh canto of Bhagavatam explains the whole Prahlad Leela. And then that person was into tears. He was an American. He had no knowledge. He was into tears that how can a father be so brutal towards his five-year-old son who is such a good boy. And how beautifully God came to save him against all the odds. You cannot kill me outside, you cannot kill me inside, you cannot kill me in daytime, you cannot kill me in nighttime, you cannot kill me as an animal, you cannot kill me as a human, not as a demigod, not with a weapon, not with this, not with that. What comprehensive insurance policy he asked for? You cannot kill me in any of the months. You cannot kill me in any of the months. January to December, you cannot kill me in any of the months. How can God kill that fellow? You tell me. Look at the mercy of Lord Narasimha. He comes, he completely obeyed to all the conditions of insurance policy. He created a new month called Adhika Mass. It's called Adhika, meaning additional mass. He reduced 1111 day from each month without anybody's awareness and created after 4 years Adhika Mass. It comes once in 4 years. Why do you think Deepavali date changes every year? Anybody question? Scientific question, Mataji? Scientific answer. He is the one who is removing one day every year. The structure is created because of stupid Hiranyakashipu's comprehensive insurance policy. Even till now our calendars are changing. There is a reason, Baba. There is a reason behind everything. It's not like, you know, just like that we are whimsically believing. Movies like Oh My God and PK might have done a good thing that they've raised questions, but unfortunately they didn't realize that people don't have answers also. Right? I give seminars in colleges. Students come and challenge me, they tell me this, but when I give answers, they surrender. Immediately they surrender. That's the beauty of preaching to students. That's the beauty of, you know, because they don't have too much baggage behind them. the more aged we are, the more less we will get right knowledge. Because so much baggage we are carrying. This Amma, that Baba, this thing, that thing. Now you are telling me not to believe in this, that, you know. How can I say, okay? It's very big baggage. But if you are coming with a clean heart, if you are coming as an atheist into this hall, you are the most advanced person. Because I can write on that white paper very easily. Isn't it? But we are coming with a lot of baggage. You have to remove a lot of baggage before you accept new baggage. Isn't it? So does God exist? Yes, He exists. But what is the way we have got this wisdom? Through this way. How can we have faith? This Draupadi, who has done that Draupadi role in Star Plus. I have put the decent picture here so that families are attending. How can I keep faith that such a person is playing such kind of a role, and this is what is religion? Today's role models. Who are your role models? Shah Rukh Khan, Angelina Jolie, maybe now Virat Kohli. Right? What is their opinion on God? Kamala Hassan. What is Kamala Hassan saying? People ask me, is yours the atheistic principle? Boldly I reply, no, atheism is my tool. Atheism is my tool. Humanitarianism is my principle. I don't believe in God. I believe in humanitarianism. What humanitarianism are you talking about? You are first of all born. And who made you as a body into the limbs? Who is pumping your heart in the night? Right? Humanitarianism is a big slogan to use, you know, to atheists are using. I am a human. I may not be a devotee. In one seminar, when many lecturers and in a big college I was giving, by mistake, I was giving a seminar on, you know, something related to personality management. By mistake, it came out of my mouth because I also preach. I told, if you are not a devotee, you are a demon. It just came out. And suddenly the whole hall became numb. I said, Mera toh band baj gaya aaj, you know. People are going to kill me out now. Because, you know, there are so many atheists sitting. By natural, 90% atheists only. How can you say that? One student got up. How can you say that? This is why I hate religion. If you are not a devotee, you are a demon. These are the statements which you know, we get irritated. Immediately, the entire hall applauded. You know, Mera toh baj gaya aaj. Then I was thinking, what should I answer? Then I told, give me 1 minute. I started drinking water. Because during water, drinking water, Krishna can give me some intelligence to answer this fellow. Because if I don't answer, you know, I have created again another fanatic statement in the name of religion. And then the answer came. You want to hear that answer? Completely spontaneously it came. I asked him, does your mother love you? He said, yes. Entire hall is hearing, 400 students are sitting, 20 professors are sitting, dean of the college is sitting, you know, and everybody is hearing attentively. How is this fellow going to support the statement? If you are not a devotee, you are a demon. How is he going to support this? Then I asked, does your mother love you? He said, yes. Do you love your mother? Do you love your mother? Yes. Are you devoted to your mother? Are you devoted to your mother? Yes. If you are not devoted to your mother, what are you? What are you? A demon. Simple. Do you love the nature? The nature that is giving you food? The nature that is giving you water? Do you love it? Yes. Are you devoted to the nature? Yes. If you are not devoted to the nature, you have no gratitude, what are you? Demon. And if there is a creator to that nature, which is so scientifically running, and you don't have any devotion towards that creator, what are you? Demon. This time nobody clapped. But I escaped that college. So, it's very easy to blame, it is very easy to point fingers on religion. But let us sit down and discuss. There is a whole science behind everything. Right? Don't follow these role models. They're good for nothing in life. If you look at their habits, look at this fellow. He is telling you who is God? He's telling, I feel very strongly about souls who are misguiding people in the name of religion. And he's following religion? Does he know what is religion? Islam considers everything to be pure. They don't smoke, they don't drink. One thing that I like about Islam. They should not be. I was standing in the New York, what is that place? No, no, you are right. Near that Statue of Liberty. We wanted to go on the Statue of Liberty, that ride, and I was standing there, Times Square, very close to Times Square. So there, it's a all hip-hop crowd going on. And I have my chanting beats with me. I have not finished my rounds. I have committed to my guru, I'll do 16 rounds every day. That day I could not do. So still 8 rounds are pending. I'm thinking, should I do my rounds or no? Should I do my rounds or no? Maybe people will think something about me. They'll think I'm religious. This is that I'm thinking. One person, one gentleman who was standing in front of me with a backpack, he just moved out of the line. He removed his backpack, removed a chadar, put it on the floor. He did namaz for 20 minutes. 20 minutes he did namaz. I was just looking at him. Everything was happening around him. All the hip-hop, so-called modern life is going on, and he's just doing his namaz. And after 20 minutes, he picked up that and he thing and he put it back inside and he stood back with a backpack with the goggles in the line. I tapped him, sir. He turned back. I touched his chest and I told, I need to learn from you how to love God. It's not about a religion. We can learn from others. When we have a grateful heart to learn, we can learn from everybody. No need to point fingers on others. A dog recognizes its master, even if the master comes in the clothes of a Batman. Even if the master wears Spider-Man clothes, dog will recognize. Even if the master wears dhoti and kurta, dog recognizes, isn't it? And if the master is not wearing any clothes also, dog recognizes. Isn't it? We should learn from a dog. How to recognize that God, even if he comes as Allah, even if he comes as Krishna, even if he comes as Christ. We should not fight in the name of religion. We should learn about that God from scriptures. People are not fighting in the name of religion because they know God. Every fellow who is fighting on the street in the name of God did not read Bhagavad Gita, I can guarantee that. He did not read Quran, he did not read Bible, nothing. It's a fanatic ego that is coming out and putting in the name of religion. How can you? There is no reason. There is no reason to fight. When that God is so merciful, when you know that my father is such a merciful person, how can you fight in the name of religion? There is no question. You don't know what he is. You want your, you know, ego to be satisfied. That is the reason you bring up religion, you bring up this, bring up that. Right? Let's go forward. Knowledge of God is considered as brainwashing, isn't it? Yes. Whoever tells that I believe in God, that means he's brainwashing me. Hey, don't tell me. Whatever you believe, you keep it. Don't tell me. Don't tell me. I am actually appreciating that so many of you have come here to listen to the SSR, because in today's day and age, nobody wants to hear from anybody. Is that true? The moment a discussion of God comes, hey, we are secular. What is the meaning of secularism? Secularism means we accept all religions. It doesn't mean we reject all religions. Right? Today there is no religion, no scripture taught in the schools. Why? In the name of secularism. But what is the meaning of secularism? What is the harm? Teach Quran, teach Bhagavad Gita, teach Bible. What is the problem? No, no. Religion aate jagada ho jayega. Kaise ko jagada hoga? If you teach it properly, where is the question of any problem? I have a lot of Muslim friends. I have a lot of Christian friends. And they are devotees also. I don't have any problem with them. They don't have any problem with me. When I sit down, I tell that your Christ in the evening, he plays a flute. Is there a problem? Can Christ play flute? Maybe he can. So that is Krishna. What is the problem? There's no problem. Right? When you have an open mind, now here you need an open mind to accept the God the way he is. Right? Then when we read from scripture, you can actually understand. When Srila Prabhupada went to America with this movement, he went and told people, and somebody came and challenged me, some press reporter came and challenged, are you trying to convert our people into Hindus? In 1965, this challenge was posted. Then what was Srila Prabhupada's answer? He said, no, I have not come here to convert anybody. I want a Christian to become a better Christian. I want a Muslim to become a better Muslim. I want a Hindu to become a better Hindu. Meaning what? Learn your religions, which you have stopped. There is no avenue, there is no teacher, there is no proper guidance. And there is only rituals that are floating around. And there is only fear of God that is floating around. And so we call it as brainwashing. Read this sentence. Religion is only subject where anyone can survive Religion is the only subject where anyone can arrive at any conclusions without any guidance or knowledge. In all other subjects, there is no argument raised when need for training is asked. After all, God is the safest thing to comment, as God never corrects you immediately. Isn't it? Four people are standing on a crossroads. They can talk about God. Is there anybody to correct them? You know the favorite subject of drunkards after they drink? God. God. Safest subject to discuss. Because nobody will come and slap, na? If you talk about his father, what will happen? Mere baap ke bare mein bolta hai, phatik lag jayega. Isn't it? But God, kaun bolega? Who will tell? If you comment on God, nobody will tell anything. Especially we Hindus, no question. Bolo tum, you believe in you, I believe in Sanatana, you believe in Dharma. Right? I believe in this, you believe in that. You believe in him, I'll believe in her. You follow, I follow. What we are following? We are not following anybody. We want convenient religion. Religion that is very convenient, you know. We will remain the way we are. God, you remain the way you are. You don't come into my life, I will not come into your life. You supply, I will supply. I will supply one aarti, you supply me money. Or you supply me whatever my desire is. That's all I need God for. I want convenient religion. I don't want a religion which will come and tell me do's and don'ts. Is that not? The moment do's, don'ts, I don't want that religion. But do you know why those do's are? Do you know why those don'ts are? Are they for your good? Are they for your bad? Nobody is explaining. Humanitarianism without God. Atheism. Hug a atheist. Right? Religion is beating humanity. See this cartoon? I thought you were born to help me. It's one of the famous cartoons in atheistic society. I thought you were born to help me. Who is beating whom? Religion is beating humanity. We can all be good without God. See, look at those faces. Freedom from religion foundation. There is a foundation also, you know, we can be free from. How many Gitas should I read? Who all have written Gitas today? How many Bhagavad Gitas are floating in the market? This fellow also is writing Gita. I'm so sorry. This fellow also is writing Gita. And see the title? No questions, only doubts. What is the meaning of that, by the way? No questions, only doubts. What is the meaning of that? Can anybody tell me the difference? Oh, very deep, sir. You know, something he was telling. No questions, only doubts. We will get his Gita. We will read his Gita. What will come out? More doubts. More doubts. This is nonsense that is going on. Right? Nobody wants to know what is there in Gita. Every person wants to write his own Gita. Can I write Gita, by the way? I'm a CA. I think I can speak 10% of the English that you speak. Can I write Gita? Of course I can write Gita. Leelananda Gita. I can write. And I'll tell you, it will sell also. Because we have so many people, fools, waiting outside for one more, you know, kind of character to write another Gita. I can introduce any kind of thing. You know, dunya is goal, right? Our sir is goal. Our eyes are goal. There is goal, goal, goal. And there is goal yoga. Goal yoga in Gachi Boli, goal. And that is your goal. And I'll keep a banner. People will come with tight pants and, you know, all that. Goal yoga seeking away. I'll make tons of money. That is how people have become today. No common sense. Anybody can cheat anybody. And I have YouTube. I can put so many videos, right? There are nice photographers I can hire for 50,000 rupees. I can become famous in just a matter of 3 months. Video pe video phekte jao. Beech mein ek joke bhi bolte jao. Khatam. You know, hore kya baat karta hai? You saw that video? Oh, very nice figure. And after some time, I put a banner. I put a banner that, you know, there is a program in the stadium. 20,000 fools will come to see that program. And I'm telling goal yoga. That is what is going on. You are using media for your own purposes. I'm sorry if I'm hurting your feelings. But that is why we don't believe in God today. Because many people are writing so many Gitas. Many people are writing so many Gitas. Why we ask general questions? When we ask general questions about God, what are the some responses? What is God? God is love. God is light. God is nature. God is power. God is everywhere, everything. God is omnipotent, God is omniscient, God is omnipresent, God is you, God is me, this is peak, you know, God is you, God is me, God is infinite, etc. Is God great? Everybody here? Please raise your hand if you think God is great. How great is God? Nobody knows. You go and knock any door in your apartment. Ask, is God great? Yes, he's great. How great is he? I don't know. According to me, that according to me is killing the religion today. According to me, if God produces little ash, he's God. If God produces some chain in the air, he's God. If God gives me some blessing that my cancer is cured, he's God. If God gives me, you know, some apartment loan is cleared, is God. If God gives me promotion, is God. Isn't it? If God appears at one place, disappears at one place, is God. If I can see him in the moon, he is God. If I can see him in the water, is God. If I can see him, is God. Have you heard of these things? How many can meet Chandrasekhar Rao tomorrow? Morning 7 a.m. He is in Hyderabad only. I got to know. Lift your hand. How many can go and meet him tomorrow at 7 a.m.? After all, Chandrasekhar Rao, who is the chief minister of, after all, Telangana. How many can go and meet him? Why you cannot meet him? Let me ask that question. Why you cannot meet him? Why? What is the time? Time check? Huh? 7? Okay. We'll finish in 20 minutes. Tell me. Why you cannot meet Chandrasekhar Rao? He's busy. We need an appointment. We need the people that he knows. We need to know the people that he knows. There has to be some connection. There has to be a good reason, some recommendation. After all, to meet a chief minister, you need so much. To see him in person, you need so much. Is God so cheap that in your contaminated consciousness, you can come and see him whenever you want, and if you can't see him, he doesn't exist? Don't you think we need a qualification to see God? For seeing, after all, chief minister, you need so many qualifications. Is God so impure? When we enter the temple, what do? We remove our chappal. How many chappals are hidden inside? How many chappals we are supposed to remove before we can access God? God is so pure. How much purity should I gain to access him? And is God expecting us to be fully pure to come in front of us? He is coming in front of us so many times, we are rejecting him. In the form of his devotees, in the form of scriptures, in the form of so many ways he's coming in front of us. We don't want. Right? So we should understand that God is great, but he is really, really great. How great is he? He is so great that the innumerable universes are floating and happen to be one of the grains. All these universes together are one grain beside an ocean sand. And there are so many universes. No NASA can find out anything. No NASA can find out anything. We are nowhere. We are right now sitting in a school in Janardana Hills, which is 0.01% of Hyderabad, and Hyderabad is not more than 1% of Telangana, and Telangana is not even 4% of India, and India is not even 7% of the whole globe, and globe is not even 10% of the whole solar system. Forget about 10%, not even 1%. And the solar system is not even 0.001% in the front of the entire universe. And this universe is not even 0.001% in front of the entire creation, which we have no clue. And I'm so egoistic, I'm sitting here and rejecting the creator of that creation, saying God doesn't exist, simply, without any knowledge. Right? Look at this. Let me just finish the ritual first. Let's not get into any trouble with God. Who knows? He might exist. Kumbh Mela gaye, gaye. Dubki mara, mara. Pushkara hua, hua. Dubki mara, mara. Pani liya, liya. Pheka, pheka, pheka. Kya hai? Is this cheapest God? You throw some water on somebody's head, he is delivered? No. This is how we are misrepresented about God. Most believe in God because of the fear of the unknown or family pressure. See, sometimes in society it's better to say that I believe in something, right? Otherwise it's difficult to mingle with people. You know, so that way also I try to say that the God exists. 99% of the atheists are 100% convinced on the existence of God. What to speak of? Atheists. Right? Theists themselves are convinced that, you know, God doesn't exist. We already discussed about most of this. So I'll go forward. You can see in the... So finally the question, does God exist? Does God exist or not? Right? I wanted to bring your atheist and keep him in the front chair. I don't know if you can see him right now or not. But everybody has atheist sitting inside us. Everybody has atheist sitting inside us. Unless we bring that atheist outside and then ask for questions and cure him, we can never understand the answer, does God exist? Now quickly, I am going to take you through some scientific understanding of does God exist. If there is an urge, there has to be a fulfillment. Do you believe in this? Can we tell one urge? Urge for thirst. What is the fulfillment? Water. Urge for hunger. What is the fulfillment? Food. Thirst. Water. Man has perverted fulfillment. Don't look into that. Liquor and all that. But basically it's water. Hunger. Food. We don't need too many other things. Sex. Whatever it is. Is there a fulfillment? Is there a fulfillment or no? It is there. There is an urge. That's a natural urge. And there is a fulfillment. Name one urge that you have which does not have a fulfillment on this planet. Tell me. One urge in this creation that does not have a fulfillment. You tell me. Think for 30 seconds. Urge. I'm not talking about emotion. Urge. Very clearly urge. That you have that does not have a fulfillment. Yes? Something? Huh? Desire is emotion. I'm not talking about emotions. I'm talking about urge. Very clear urge. Love again is emotion. Yeah, for love there is a fulfillment, right? You want to be loved, your mother is there, your child is there, your spouse is there. Yes. You put a very nice point. Is there an urge to pray? Is there an urge to pray when you are in trouble? Even if you are an atheist, you will pray. Even if you don't believe in God, when the situation comes, your palms will go together. You don't know who he is. You don't know where he exists. Bachalo. Urge to pray is natural. Just like eating, just like thirst, urge to pray is also natural. So if there is every other urge which has a fulfillment, don't you think urge to pray also has a fulfillment? Is it a scientific way of understanding? Yes.
Why does it say that only, let's say, straight sex is natural?
I'll get back to that answer later. I know that's a big fanatic debate going on. Okay. Religion is not against it, but you need a scientific answer. I'll tell you. Why a male and female come together? What is the outcome? I'm asking a question, you tell the answer. What comes when unstraight things come together? Life comes out? So that is not natural, as simple as that. Right? We can discuss after the class.
Sure.
Okay, yeah. Because there are children, I don't want to get into too much. Okay, so there is an urge, there is a fulfillment. When there is an urge, there is a fulfillment. So obviously there is a natural urge to pray also. There has to be a fulfillment, and that is God. Whatever name you give it, no problem. Whatever name you give it. I'm not getting into name of God at this point. Right? This is one way of analyzing that God exists. There is some like power, if you can say, or a person, you can say, there is some authority that is existing which is more powerful than us, who has a power to save us in our difficult situations. Is that true? Yes. Let's go further. Creation implies creator. Isaac Newton, he created this whole model. He created a model of solar system. This is a true example if you read the biography. He was actually a believer in God, being a scientist. And his friends came to his house and he said, I'm having breakfast, you can wait in the front room. And they saw this model. And they looked at the model And they told, oh wow, what a creation. All the planets are moving. Who created this whole mechanic tool and everything? Isaac Newton came back and told, no, it did not get created. It just appeared like that. He said, well, come on, Newton, tell me, when did you get it done? Which workshop you got it done? No, I didn't get it done. I kept some balls and some rods here. By morning, it became like that. They told Newton, this is too much. You know, we are asking you. Then he told, I am also asking you. How can you tell this whole universe is just by fluke rotating around in such a right sequence? If that is what you call as science, how can this be science? Make sense? This is the answer given by Newton. If I tell you this watch on the ocean sand is created because waves have hit the stone, will you agree? How many will agree? Tell me. If I tell this watch is created on the ocean by waves hitting the sand, it's a nonsense. It is created by some factory, isn't it? An eye that we see, you know how many megapixel the eye can see? You know how many megapixel? As per science, which is still understanding the way eye works, 5,000 megapixels is what our eye can see. That is what science has so far achieved. Nobody can create eyeball. Forget about creating any other thing. No scientist can create eyeball. He only has to transport one eyeball to another eyeball. And by the way, after doing that operation, next day morning, doctor is in full tension because doesn't know it working or not. Have you seen in movies? पट्टी लगा एक पट्टी अभी दिख रहा है आपको अभी दिख रहा है आपको भगवान दिखा दो उसको नो डॉक्टर कैन डू एनीथिंग एंड बाय द वे एंटायर मेडिकल सिस्टम इज वर्किंग ऑन ओनली वन प्रिंसिपल दैट इफ द इम्यून पावर इज नॉट सेविंग ए पर्सन वी कैन नॉट सेव एनीबडी हू इज गिविंग दैट इम्यून पावर इन साइड अस कैन साइंटिस्ट क्रिएट स्किन विच इज सो थिन हार्डली 1 millimeter skin, there are several layers, I'm talking about the topmost layer, hardly 1 millimeter skin, if I remove, I will get infected and I'll die. It is saving us from so many natural problems outside the body, and this 1 millimeter skin is so great that it produces itself if it is cut. And it is always nourishing itself whenever there is a problem. It adjusts to different temperatures. Is there no creator? I mean, think about it. Is there no creator? Have you seen mosquitoes outside? Sometimes they're going on your head. Have you seen one mosquito bumping into each other? There will be sometimes 200 mosquitoes on top of your head, but not a single mosquito will bump into each other. What pilots they are. I was thinking one day, what pilots? Can any human pilot do that? Ask them to take out all the flights and go around like this? Not on your head, but in the sky. There is one show that happens in San Francisco. How many have been to San Francisco? Any time in your life? Yeah. It's called Blue Angels Show. It happens on Pier 39. Once in a year. Blue Angels are the most fastest pilots in the planet. They are the selected pilots. They go at a pace more higher than sound. When you sit there, the fighter jets will go, whoop, they'll go like this. And after they go, you're wondering what happened, and then the sound comes. After they go, after 4-5 seconds, the sound comes. They are going faster than sound. Under the, you know, what is that bridge? I forgot. The Golden Gate. They go under that, through the Alcatraz Islands. Go to YouTube and say, the Blue Angels, you'll see. And they go so close, 1 feet away from each other, four flights go. 1 feet away in the air they are going. Even if one pilot goes a little like this, all the four are dead. They cannot survive. And they have so many accidents where Blue Angels have died. Right? This is the best pilots on the planet. According to me, mosquitoes are better pilots than them. They never bump into each other. Bats don't have any eyes. Have you seen the way bats go around? They don't have any eyes. They just work with radioactive signals. You know, some signals that are going around. They never bump into anybody. Even if you stand in between bats, not a single bat will come and beat you. They'll go right across you, but they'll not come and touch you. What technology is this? Is there no creator? By the way, in Africa, suddenly at one place, all bats were dying. Scientists could not understand what's going on. National Geographic Channel is running. Why bats are dying? Let's find out something. After years of research, they found out that there is one small beetle. There is one small beetle. That beetle, wherever it is going, bats are dying. They are like, what is this beetle? And they found out that this beetle is producing some rays which are breaking the signals of the bats. And they kept that beetle in a room, all the bats in a room, the bats are moving, the beetle is there, all the bats are bumping into each other and they're dying. Then US Army took that beetle into a separate place. We want to use the technology of this beetle to break the signals of enemy soldiers, you know, the signals. This is called creation and creator. And there can be thousands of examples, I'll not spend time on that. Okay, one for the children. You know the way an eagle comes down to get its prey? At what pace it comes down? 400-500 kilometers per hour at the pace at which an eagle comes down at its prey. We can't even believe that. Even a 707 flight might just match near to that speed. And in that speed, can you see anything with these eyeballs? Sometimes you keep your window, your head out of the window of the car itself, you can't see anything. And that is hardly 70 kilometer speed, right? 80 kilometer speed. Think of an eagle and see the creator. Because the eagle has to make such a hunt, there are three eyelids eagle has. Three eyelids. One eyelid just comes down when it is going to jump and that eyelid is completely transparent. Now, is there no creator? Is there no science behind it? People will say, Prabhuji, that is evolution, na? Apna Darwin hai na? Exactly. The evolution hai na? That is a beautiful logic we have, na? Okay. Where did we come from? Where did we come from? Who are your ancestors? Bolo na. Monkeys? No, who are your ancestors?
Some humans.
Before that? Bol do. Are you really convinced? Are we just passing exam by writing that? If we came from monkeys, why are still monkeys around? They forgot to get evolved? I'm asking a simple question. And you know what Darwin's final statement is? I think the missing link is still to be established. Missing link. He could never come to a conclusion. He talked about evolution. It came into the textbooks. But there is no proof. By the way, the so-called great scientific theories that we have written CBSE exams and passed our exams have no proof behind them. We have just passed our exams. Big Bang Theory. How many have heard this? Big Bang Theory. Do you believe in that?
I don't have much knowledge.
Yeah, but Big Bang Theory, what does it mean? What is Big Bang Theory?
To understand the evolution.
Yes, part of the evolution. It comes in one of the stages. Big Bang Theory. A big blast happened in the universe. Something blasted from nothing. It created everything and that everything is everywhere. Everything is everywhere. What a beautiful scientific statement, isn't it? Something blasted out of nothing, and that nothing has created everything, and that everything is everywhere. This is scientific. I'll ask you a simple question. Keep a bomb in this room. Sorry, the owners are not here, but keep a bomb in this room. Blast this room. What will come out of it? Waterfalls? Mountains? People? Living beings? Different faces? Different hairstyles? What will come out of a blast? When blast in Bombay happened, what came out of it? When Hiroshima bomb was blasted in Japan, what came out of it? Beautiful sceneries? What came out of it? Nothing came out. I'll tell you the biggest funny thing. After the Big Bang Theory was written, there are so many scientists which challenge that scientist. And there are... What is that sound? Can you remove that phone? No, give me that phone. It's not the phone ringing. I don't know. Okay, so, you know, after the Big Bang Theory came out, several scientists challenged that Big Bang Theory. And they actually found out that that is the foolest theory that has ever discovered by a scientist. You know why? They said the blast has happened. I'm giving only few examples. You can actually go and write Big Bang conspiracy on internet. You'll go mad. How did I study this and get marks also? right? They, one person asked, when the Big Bang happened, all the objects are supposed to go in one direction, right? Is that not normal? It's normal, right? I mean, like, if a blast happens, everything blast comes out and everything travels in one direction. One person clearly showed that actually they are going in different directions after some time. How is it possible? They're saying universe is expanding. If it is expanding, it should expand according to the bang. How come one star is going this side, another is going front and again coming back? There is something apart from Big Bang that is happening. Another person asked even fundamental question. How come the speed of the objects is increasing? He had no answer. It's not possible, right? When a bang happens, when a blast happens, as it settles down, the space should decrease. How come it is increasing? There is no answer for that. There are so many theories which have been brought out of Big Bang and the evolution theory which have no answers.
Maybe I'm sounding strong.
No, that's okay. That's okay. Even I'm sounding strong. Have we agreed to it without knowledge? Have we agreed to it without knowledge? Have we agreed to the evolution without knowledge? So without complete agreement, how come it is there in our syllabus? How come it is there in our syllabus? No. Don't tell me all that. You told. Let's have a clear debate. I'm telling. So work on it and then publish, na? You can work on it and then publish, na? See, I'll tell you, I'll give you something to drink. And tomorrow I'll come and tell, by the way, it was pesticide. What will your answer be? No, what will your answer be? Plastic, for example. They introduce crocin, they introduce anacin, they introduce these. Now those tablets are considered to be poisonous after 12 years of we consuming it. Who is taking responsibility? I'm not against science. I'm absolutely a scientific person. But if somebody says that science means I will present anything that I want and it's evolving, that's ridiculous. You present it when you prove it. Don't present anything in between and tell that is science. Science has to be scientific, right? It has to be scientific. And science is not always coming out of visible principles. Like Isaac Newton, he saw an apple falling down. If I would have been there, I would have just eaten it. But he looked at that apple, it's falling down. There has to be some invisible principle behind this apple falling down. Then he came up with gravity. And he came up with a gravity number. What is that number? 9.82. G is equal to 9.82. Now, sometimes it is going to 12.2 in laboratories. They're saying, you better correct it to 9.82 because he told it. Right? So, see, I'm not insulting scientists, but at the same time, you should understand, science is still trying to understand how this creation has happened. It has no conclusion. There is no conclusion. Unfortunately, but they are showing it in such a way that we know better than the Creator Himself. I understand the world better than Creator Himself. That should not be the way. Even I have children, they're studying in school. I only tell them, God is great, His creation is great. We are trying to understand it through science. That's good. Is that good? That is right. But if science is saying there is no God, some Big Bang happened and everything has come into place, I will not accept that. And you have no right to tell that because you have not proven it. Make sense? How they are happening? No, but you're telling it's fine, but I'm asking a simple question. Who is pumping your heart in the night? No. How is it natural? Create a heart. Keep a heart with all the veins, or get a dead body. Let me put a simple question. You get a dead body beside you and say pump, 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 pump. It'll pump? So what is the difference between you and a dead body? Who is pumping your heart? Who is not pumping your heart, the dead body's heart? Scientific question. Switch on, switch off. You tell me. Who is putting the switch on for you, switch off for him? What is that? Sorry?
They're no
No, but why are they not working? Who switched it off? And who is that energy which is pumping? Do you know that your heart is pumping right now? Who is pumping it? Do you know that you are breathing right now? Who is pushing those lungs? Who is pushing those lungs? See, I'll tell you very simple. When we want to see, when we have a gratitude to see the person who is doing it for us, we can see it. But when we want to not see him, we can simply say that it is happening. I'm asking a simple question. When you go and order a meal for dinner in a hotel, right? You go to some hotel here nearby, I don't know which hotel, Minerva Hotel. You went to Minerva and told, get me set dosa. Is set dosa coming by itself or somebody is making it inside? Come on. It's happening naturally. No, no. Set dosa is coming naturally, Baba. I am asking a simple question. Set dosa is coming naturally is my conclusion. What do you say this answer? Set dosa is coming naturally. It is just coming naturally. You are telling me your heart is pumping naturally. Take it in a very kind. We are not arguing. Just in the right spirit. Yeah. I am just telling you. I am just trying to unveil the truth out of you. You are saying that your heart is pumping naturally. I am telling set dosa is coming naturally. Tell me what is the difference? Somebody is making your heart pump, and you are saying somebody is making the set dosa inside the kitchen. Is that right? That's what I am saying. I am saying somebody is pumping your heart. When you are believing in somebody making set dosa, why can't you believe that somebody is pumping your heart? So if I allow you to see, you will believe. Is that right? So let's get prepared to see. Don't reject just because you don't see. You can't reject just because you don't see. Isn't it? Because I cannot see. Can anybody tell, has anyone seen God in this planet?
We are yet to order the sentence.
Can anyone tell that no one has seen God on this planet? You cannot tell because you have not spoken to everybody. As simple as that. Actually, we are more scientific than the way science is projecting itself. Only it's a question of questioning it. Right? In the interest of time, this can go on forever, but Big Bang Theory already discussed about it, right? This beautiful fall colors don't come with from Big Bang, by the way. You know, the whole Big Bang Theory is a hoax. The whole evolution is a joke that is created by scientists to promote atheism, that everything is coming from nothing. And there is no conclusion for it. There is no conclusion for it. They have not concluded a point. They have still so many unanswered questions. Why is this part of does God exist topic? Because we have to pull that scientist out of our heads. Because our education system is into our veins. Our education system is in our veins. It is making us believe. You know, what if I say God can throw a shaving razor in the air, and he'll just rotate his face and his entire shaving is complete. Will you believe? God can do that. He can do that. You can't do it. Doesn't mean God can't do it. What if I say there is a whole iron pillars? What if I say there are all iron pillars and you shot a bullet? What is your name, Mataji, by the way? Malati. Yes. There are whole iron pillars, steel pillars in this room. And I'm shooting a bullet. I'm not Rajinikanth, but I'm still shooting. Right? And the bullet hits all the steel pillars and the name Malati is, you know, inscribed on one of the pillars. Is it possible? God can do it. Just because you can't do it, you can't see him, doesn't mean we conclude that it cannot be done. Right? We should understand that aspect. But if we have a clear vision to see, right? I've already discussed most of this. Here, Krishna is saying in Bhagavad Gita, very clearly saying, Aham sarvasva prabho matta sarvam pravartate iti matva bhajante maam buddha bhava samanvita. He's saying very clearly. What is the meaning of this? I am the creator of the spiritual world and the material world. And everything that is coming is emanating from me. If he is making such a statement, let's find out who this person is. Let's find out more evidence about this person. Scripture, I'm not saying believe just because he told it. But there is some level of intelligence that is coming from a higher authority. Right? There are so many laws that are governing us. Law of vibration, law of relativity, law of cause and effect, law of rhythm, law of gestation. So many laws. How come if there are so many laws, there is no lawmaker? If there is signals, if you remove signals from our Gachibowli signal, what will happen tomorrow morning? So there is a signal needed to control things. So if there are so many signals that are there, which science itself is seeing in the nature, how can, see, simple, pendulum. The pendulum has to go like this, it has to come back like this. Where is this law given? Who created this law? Who created the gravity? If gravity law is not there, and the movement law is not there, cause and effect law is not there, no science can exist, by the way. No experiment can happen in any laboratory. Who is behind these laws? Come on, ask an intelligent question. If there is a law, there has to be a lawmaker. Who is giving shapes to all of this? Just because, okay, God is a person or not. We think that. Let me put this last thing and we are done. God is a person or not. What is the problem in accepting God as a person? Prabhuji, he is limited, na? If he's a person, he's limited, isn't it? God means he should be unlimited. You know? Why are we limiting him as a person? I'm asking a simple question. If I blast this whole room into powder, is the room right now limited? Is the room right now limited? Yes, it is limited. If I blast this, it will become like powder. Will it become unlimited? It is still limited only. But you can't see it in a limited way. Right? God is so big and so great that even though he is limited, for us he is always unlimited. He can be a person also. What is the problem? I'll tell you why people don't accept God as a person. Because the moment he is a person, he'll have demands. Better to keep him as energy. Kaay ko bekar mein usko, you know. If he comes, you know, he'll tell me, do this, don't do this. Again, he'll have tastes also. I have to fulfill his tastes. Better keep him energy. That is how atheism starts. Why don't we accept that God is a person? Nobody has a comment. Christianity is saying, though the image is coming from me, Christ is saying, the image of a man is coming from me. He is telling, my own image I have given him. Human being among all the species, 8.6 million species are there, by the way. No evolution is happening. 8.6 million species, Vedic scriptures are clearly saying, God has created and they always exist, will always exist. Hanumanji is not a monkey. Hanumanji is a Kimnara. Can you all say Kimnara? Kimnara. Vedic script, if you read Ramayana, it says Kimnara. Hanumanji is a Kimnara. Kimnara means, Nara means human. Kimnara means, is he a human? He is a kind of human. You know how many kinds of human beings are there? 400,000 types of human beings are there. And only one type we are seeing on this planet. This is Vedic science. Next session is very, very important. Because I am going to give you tons and tons of proofs from scriptures which will bewilder you that how come they were mentioned 5,000 years ago or written 5,000 years ago, how come they were revealed millions of years ago. You will be shocked, I am telling you. You will be shocked. When I am a scientific person myself, I am not going to believe in religion without any proof. I was bewildered and I surrendered that this is not possible. This cannot be possible. There has to be somebody who has given all this in writing. That is why it is happening like this. It is also explained what is going to happen in future. Religion is not just talking about the past. It will also tell what is going to happen in the future, and it will happen. Right? Laws implies a lawmaker, like I told about the traffic. Yes, even the bullet train system which Japan told is completely fault free. One day it came up with a permutation and combination, the trains crashed because they could not figure out a permutation combination. Right? Everything has a logic. It is impossible to notice the laws of nature. It is impossible. If you have a vision, a clear vision, you can see God in everything. You can see God in everything. God is everywhere. But we are refusing to accept it because we can't see Him. But you can see his actions. You only told in the beginning that there is some superpower. I am ready to accept that. But behind that power is a powerful person. Behind the energy is the energetic. Behind the intelligence is the intelligent. Right? Behind the art, there is an artist. Do you accept that? Behind the art, there is an artist. As simple as that. They are great scientists. They are telling, they have written books saying that it is impossible to accept that God does not exist. You know, there are so many, and this is, by the way, our universe right now. Even if 1.01 change is made in the way Earth and Sun is situated, we will be underwater. Scientists themselves have concluded. How come that preciseness is being maintained? Look at the conclusion of this scientist. Just let's read one of them. This scientist is saying, a bit of science distances one from God, but much science nears one to him. The more I understand, the more I study nature, the more I stand amazed at the work of the Creator. It is impossible the way we are existing. I'll tell you, in science, remember these words, in science, God comes at the end. In religion, God comes at the beginning. That is the only difference. Science is saying, I'll do this, finally, I don't know how it's functioning, maybe there is God. But religion is more smarter, is saying, there is God, now let me understand His creation. Through His knowledge. Right? If you read Srimad Bhagavatam, which will be part of the next session, you will be shocked to see the amount of detail that is given about a baby inside the embryo. Even doctors are not able to understand how a Vedic scripture can explain that level of detail. Right? Again, material nature is working as per God's direction. We know that. Look at the shloka in Bhagavad Gita. Mayadhikshena prakriti suyate sa characharam hetunanena kaunteya jagat viparivartate. He is saying, this material nature is working according to my direction. Direct statement. There is no discussion here. And who is material nature? Durga. We are all doing Durga Puja and Navratri. And on whose direction is Durga working? On Narayan's direction. Krishna's direction. She is working. She do this. She is doing it for him. Everything is working according to the direction of a great person. Now, definition of God. Very simple. People, you know, one person is reading newspaper. He is seeing, you know, Hey Ma. And somebody is reading from outside, is seeing Hema Malini. Right, so you can see the same thing in two directions and you can come with your own conclusions. Right, who is God, definition of God. People say, you know, like I told about that example of watermelon, right? You can come with your rational understanding and try to understand God, you'll never understand. Everyone's definition is different. According to me is the biggest virus that is spreading, which will kill our religion. There is no according to me. First understand what is there in the scriptures. Then you put according to me. Your intelligence is needed. I'm not saying come dumb to a class. But first understand what is there inside the scriptures. Why don't we just read and understand? We can do a study. We all can have a scientific debate in a scripture. And we can then understand and say, okay, according to me, God is beautiful. That's a much better conclusion than saying, according to me, I don't believe in anything. Right? Let's read the scripture. Like I told, you know, God is yours, God is mine, God is this. God is the cheapest thing to talk about today. Anybody can say anything about God, right? There are two things that are infinite in this universe. There are two things that are infinite. Who is telling this? Einstein is saying. One is universe and second is human stupidity. He is saying, you know. There is no limit to that. They are infinite. Definition of God. He is the source of everything. Understand? You ask for a definition of God, sir? This is the definition of God. If you want to declare anybody as God, he should be the source of everything. Not source of one city, not source of this, not source of that. He should be a source of everything. If you have an ancestral house, who built it? Your grandfather. What was there before that? What was there before that? Ultimately, the final before is where God comes. The cause of everything. First of all, he should be the source of everything. Right? All universes, everything. Second, he should be the supreme controller. Is Narendra Modi controlling the satsang? No. But God is controlling everything. He should be the controller of everything, right? Next, he should be the supreme proprietor of everything. Everything is owned by him only. Everything is for his enjoyment only. Everything is owned by him ultimately. You might be the owner of this land or this plot. After you die, there will be some other owner, but the land is always remaining only. We are like fools changing documents, but the land is always there and is owned by God, right? I'm going a little fast. There are a lot of examples. We are not even the proprietor of our own body. Sometimes we are laughing, sometimes we are a dead body. Right? We think we are a proprietor of so many things. Even this body that is on you, with cheeks and blood, is not your own. It can be snatched away from you without your permission. Remember that. And by the way, God is a supreme enjoyer. This is the ultimate definition of God which Vedic scriptures is giving. Ultimately, see, I went to Gokul chat one time. You know the Gokul chat in... You know, many years back I used to go there. So then one night I went after second show. I went at like 12 o'clock. At that time one Marwadi came. He came in a Maruti van that time. He opened his trunk. All covers of cash, he kept it inside and he went. All the workers are still working. Who is the enjoyer? That owner, isn't it? And who are working? Everybody else is working. Creation, maintenance and destroyer doesn't make anyone God. That is the lowest understanding of God. Creation means a lot of work, isn't it? Has anybody done construction in life? Is it easy? Working with labor? Working with this? Working with Brahmas? It's not easy. How difficult is maintenance? Even to destroy it takes so much time. Recently I had to destroy an old house and construct a new house. Such a big pain, you know, to destroy in a brutal fashion. So what is the meaning of it? So the cheapest understanding of God is, God is a creator, God is a maintainer, God is a destroyer. No. They are external functions of God, which he outsources, like we are outsourced from America, which other functions do. God is the enjoyer. If God is also working, there is a problem. There should be somebody should enjoy also. God is the enjoyer. Right? We should understand that. Ultimately, everything, creator, maintenance and destroyer, that's all done by others, energies of God. But he is the Bhoktaram Yajnatapasam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram Suhrudam Sarvabhutanam Gyatma Mam Shantim Richati. Krishna is saying, I am the enjoyer of all Bhokta. Any yajna you perform, I am enjoying it. I am not creating. I am not destroying. Lord Shiva is sent for that. Vishnu is sent for maintenance. Creation is done by Brahma. That's okay. That is their business. I am not here to do all that. I am here to enjoy. Because God is an enjoyer. So what is the definition of God? Proof of enjoyer is, he has to be the proprietor. Proof of proprietorship is, he has to be the controller. Proof of controllership is, he has to be the creator. Proof of creator is, he has to be the cause of all causes. Very scientific, isn't it? If you want to be the proprietor, you should own it first. Then only you can be the proprietor. Then only you can enjoy it. So everything is working upside down. So Srila Prabhupada is saying, anyone who claims himself as God, G-O-D, God, is actually D-O-G, dog. Nobody can claim himself as God. No human can say, I am God, ever. Very simple test I'll put to prove anybody as God. You bring that person in front of me. Simple test, difficult test. Ask him to lift Govardhan. How many have seen Govardhan Hill? 24 square kilometers. Go and lift that mountain. I'll accept that he is God. That is a little difficult test. Let's put moderate test. Ask him to read all shlokas of Bhagavatam non-stop. You are God, right? You can't remember your own scripture? Read. No, that I cannot do. Okay, let's put the most least third class test. I'll give him food. You know, I'll offer him food once given by 100 villages. Can he eat this much food? He can only eat this much. After that, say paid bargya. If you're God, right, you can eat unlimited. You can drink unlimited water. You should be able to control your urine. Why all that? You can control your grey hair. Then you're God. So many people without knowledge of scriptures are accepting Tom, Dick and Harry as gods and telling them as Bhagawan, Bhagawan this, Bhagawan that. You know the meaning of Bhagawan? Bhagawan is not a cheap word to be used for politicians or some godmans. Bhagawan means the one with all opulences, which we'll discuss in the 8th session. What is God? How great is God? We should understand before we declare anybody as God. Right? Okay, so attend all remaining sessions of SSR and you'll have answers to all these questions that I just mentioned in the beginning. I'm sorry to hurt your sentiments, if I have hurt your sentiments, and sorry to extend this session because unfortunately I couldn't plan my first session on mantra meditation within time. And I humbly request you, don't treat these sessions as an extension of time. This is God's intervention in your lives to tell you who He is. Don't treat this cheaply. This is your real investment of a Sunday evening. You would have gone to a movie or some unrequired or uninvited guest might come and ruin your evening and it might be delayed again. But this is an intervention of God. And all these great people who are serving there, they are in anxiety. Already a note is sent to me. Stop your lecture. I didn't open this because you know why? I care more than your time, I care for you. Because I want you to get the knowledge from scriptures. And please, Mataji, please forgive me. I didn't mean to argue with you. No. really, I didn't mean to argue with you. But I wanted you to unveil, because as she said, our children are asking this question, we don't have an answer. We better have an answer. Right? And these questions will be answered. Be rest assured, God does exist. And we will go to the next session on scriptures. Please don't miss it. And for the next 2 weeks, please chant one round of Hare Krishna mantra. That's my humble request. You will not lose anything by doing so. You have the chanting beads. As I said, you can leave a little donation for those beads that we got from there, or you just take it for free. Doesn't matter. God is giving everything to everybody. And those books are there, beautiful books, which are given by my friend. They've been imported here so that you can read some very easy novel-like books like Journey Home, Journey Within. And of course, Bhagavad Gita is also there. Those, I have to give money to somebody because he has given it to me, so you can take it at a price that's put it out there, kept out there. You can see the price backwards or Amazon, you can see the price, you'll be surprised. But I'm bringing this, making them accessible for you so that you can read it. That is the only thing we wish. Right? So please forgive me. I'm your humble servant, trying to be your servant. And in this process, if I hurt your heart, please forgive me like you forgive your maid servant. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Let me stop this.